Shaking. Hello and welcome to episode 7 here on the Diamond Society server. I am your host, Hodag, and I am way over here on top of a giant pillar. I am up at Y equals 130 right now, and if you're wondering why I'm up here, it's because that is the optimal AFK platform height for our slime farm. And I thought, you know, I could just build a platform up there and have the slimes transported up there, but what fun would that be, really, you know? So instead, you know what would be really fun? To build a giant tree right where this pillar is, with sugarcane and slime traveling up the center of it, sugarcane automatically growing on the outside of the tree, and you fly in with your elytra straight into the tree to a giant storage section that is automatically transporting and sorting the sugarcane and the slime all together in one giant area, like a boss. That is how we do things here. Let's just zoom in, all right? That guy right there. That guy. That's me. Okay, I do that. So the first thing we got to do, we got to make room for our tree. Actually, something we didn't do last episode is we got to look at how much slime is coming down off of this farm when I'm standing up at 130 AFK. Look at all the slimes, and they're all going to fall down. And look at how much slime is already collected on our magma blocks. Look at, if you just fly down the row here, look at all the slime balls. Oh man, don't worry about despawning. I did check that in the last episode. I told you guys that it only takes like a minute or two for that slime cart to get, not the slime cart. Well, yeah, let's call it the slime cart. The slime cart underneath the magma blocks only takes about a minute or two to travel all the way around and collect everything. I think even twice. It only takes like a minute for it to travel in and then another minute back out. So yeah, only like a minute and it covers all the spaces. You know what? I didn't know we'd be having this much slime, actually. I think our major problem is going to be... I don't know if this is enough hoppers to collect all the slime. Oh, man. We might have to rethink that. It's not a bad problem, though. And you guys, check it out. I am not the only one on the server right now. There's only three of us that are actually in different areas. And I think one of those guys is in the nether as well. So this is pretty good. But you know what? The surface is not completely lit up. There's still caves that are being loaded. But look at, there's like slime on every single floor. Yeah. All right. Now it's time to make room for that tree. All right, everybody. I'm down here by the slime farm. And the hole is dug up there above. And we're going up there. It's just we're going to take the long way because we're extending our slime... Whoop, not like that. We're extending our little slime elevator here up all the way up there. So once we get up there, you'll be able to see exactly what's up. We're going to lose some slime and bricks in the process here. I never usually let stuff despawn, but right now it's okay, guys. You guys, I got so much cobblestone and so much slime that we will never run out. Okay? Ever. And I know I'm not filling in the back corners here, but that is because... You know what, you guys? It's extra wood. You don't need to waste an extra couple stacks of wood, okay? Now, the reason that I wanted to do this on camera, though, with you guys, is because I wanted to say that some of you I know who are, like, the super efficient players, I'm usually exactly like you, okay? Whereas, you know, I want the most efficient farm, and there are going to be things that I've already thought of with the slime farm and also with the sugarcane farm and things that are coming up, that because of the actual design, I'm going to be doing some things that are wasteful. Not just with, like, wasting this stuff here. I mean, as soon as these one stack of jungle logs are out of my inventory, I'll start picking up that stuff, so. But no. For instance, just after I finished this slime farm behind me, or at least got it to this point, I looked online, I saw Il Mango had a farm. If you don't know Il Mango plays on the SciCraft server, I believe. And if you haven't heard of the SciCraft server, I'd suggest checking it out, because those are the guys who play Minecraft but, like, read the game code in Minecraft, and they will figure out the most efficient, crazy ways to build everything and anything. And they build it to an extent where you're just like, oh my god. Like, you did not know Minecraft could be played in such a way. And you're just, like, blown away the whole time. You just, like, I can't explain. Anyway, I saw his farm, and it was something like 18,000 slime balls per hour. Now, if you calculate that out to how many stacks of slime, basically you would only ever have to AFK for like 1 hour at this slime farm on a server, and it would produce enough. Oh man, my slime just fell. That's sad. It would produce enough slimes for an entire server forever. Like one hour, and you would never have to do any more AFK at the thing ever again. And so I was like, I saw it and was like, oh, I want that thing. But then I was like, are you serious? Why does any server even need that kind of ridiculous efficiency? Like, it doesn't. It doesn't ever need that. Okay, my farm already has produced more slime than almost anybody will ever use, and we have Howitzer's farm on here producing slime, and together we're going to produce enough that the server's never going to need any more slime. So I'm happy with what we got. I will make mine slightly more efficient. I think I'm going to add some iron golems on the side so they jump off here quicker. What else am I going to do? I'm going to light up the jungle above it some more as I get going further here. And that's all going to make it more efficient. But as it is right now, you guys, I've kind of tested it out, and it is working at a rate where we will never really need any more efficiency than what we already have. So I'm cool with it. All right, you guys. It's a big step in my life. Usually I'm like, it must be the best ever and produce so much that we will choke on slime. That's usually how I do just about every farm. Don't get me wrong, I'm still going to make farms that are basically ridiculous and unnecessary. But yeah, it's going to be alright. Alright, I don't know how much higher we have to make this, because we have to make sure the hoppers start here at this level. Okay, so I don't need to go that high. Uh-oh. Maybe down 2? Oh, sorry. I don't want to shoot myself. I don't know why I have that in my offhand. We're almost to the top, then I'm going to run over and show you guys the giant hole kind of deal, but I'm live streaming just after I finish this clip here. I just wanted to get it done real quick. You know what? I'm going to need space to work. I'm just dumb working on camera. Keep going. Yeah. Okay, good. So let's do this. Let's just go up to that height. And I can start picking up more things too, because that fell out. I kind of want that. Even though we have an iron farm, I'm still picking up all the iron that I get. And it's not even that. It's we have an iron farm that is super... how would I say? It's super cheap. That's what I should say. Cortez is, in my opinion, is charging almost nothing for the iron. It's awesome for me, actually. Yeah, we want it at this level. This is where the hopper minecarts... No, the hoppers are going to start. Now, for our purposes, I just want to do this right now. Do I have any torches on me? I think I have torches in one of these things, but because I'm just going to tunnel to the middle right now, you guys. Oh, there's my torches. I'm on top of the farm. There we go. I made it. Look at my beacons here. This is the very center of the farm, and look at that tunnel. Woohoo! So, I did that. Actually, it didn't take me that long. And... yeah, now I have to continue a glass, brown stained glass, and then later I'm going to come and dot it with whatever, but centered around this beacon, and we're going to go straight up with brown stained glass in a 3x3 formation, because we're going to have another elevator right here that picks up a sugarcane eventually, and our slime, and carries it all the way up to about, the AFK platform will be at Y130, and then... so this is going to have to carry it up even further than that, maybe all the way up to Y140, and currently we're on 49, so almost 90-ish blocks up from this point right here. And then I think on the live stream I'm going to have you guys help me out with designing exactly how my kind of path, walking path up here is going to go, so that I am not wasting any slime and it looks cool and all that stuff. So, yeah. And here was what we have for our mock-up for what we're kind of planning for this whole, the 8 floors that we have around here, you guys. We got kind of a pattern like this. I'm going to try to mimic kind of what I have in there, but slightly different. You know, we got the mossy stone bricks. We got the jungle wood for sure. Lighting it up, though, I want to put those lights on the walls, kind of cover them with this. And then also another thing that I forgot to kind of do here is every once in a while, because we're going to kind of make this the same, but also we want to give it some depth, you know? So, like, every once in a while, throw some buttons on the wall, throw some mixed up different blocks on the wall like this, throw some vines on the wall, and I think that'll kind of give it a good texture for the walls all around on every floor. And then on the floor here, the corner here will be like this, but then through here, I don't have any more wood stairs, but we'll put some wood stairs. I might every once in a while put in, like, a mossy stone brick just to look like that's kind of broken up and patched, and then every once in a while I'll place one of these. I'm kind of stuck between the pumpkin behind or the magma block with a torch, you know, that makes it basically have a higher light level. I think the pumpkin is too light. I want to kind of have this be spooky. I want to make sure that there's no spawning spaces, clearly. Like this right here wouldn't work out very well. So if the magma blocks are too dark, I might have to go with pumpkins. But I don't want to make everything in here super bright, so we'll have to see what we get with that. I'm going to go ahead and do like all 8 of these floors and put in stairs and everything, and it's going to take a long time, but I'm going to do that. While I'm doing that, you guys get to see my second Abba caving, okay? I did some more Abba caving. What happened is all of the losers of the first round had to meet up and play against each other because otherwise, I was going to have a bye for the second week, and that was going to be quite boring for me. Well, not boring, but boring because that's just lame. Nobody wants a bye. The action. We got to get the action, so the caving. So, guess who the winner of all the losers was? It was BC. And let's go see how we did in the Abba caving against BC.
We both have flowers.
Isn't the yellow flower like friendship and stuff anyway?
Yes, it is. I didn't know that, but it can be.
It's like a friendship flower.
Although it's about to not be friendship soon, because it's going down. And go!
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. We go. Are, okay, all right. Sorry, that was taking too long. It was go time, man. Oh, jeez. Oh, what are the, I don't even care, I'm going.
Oh, and if you die, that's it, man. There's no, you're dead, you're gone. Like, you don't get to, whatever you had is out. And if I find your stuff, it's mine.
Ah, you're just adding rules as we go here, man.
Except for your personal gear. Well, I mean, you know, you wanted to rush it, so whatever rules weren't spelled out.
Oh, no. Oh,
whoa,
no.
Spider spawner. Oh, gosh.
I'm in such a bad area right now. All right. I need to get some blocks.
Lower here. Webs are no buenos. I say that for your community.
I don't remember how much points systems are. That's not good.
Don't worry about it.
Yeah. Oh, like, geez.
Nay returned.
I'm gonna die.
Go ahead, die.
I don't
want to. Just embrace it.
So I'm gonna die.
Where's my water?
Oh, you brought water?
What are you, a noob?
Yes, very much so. No! No! Oh!
Yes. Oh.
Oh, we're good.
So my last little adventure with in the loser's bracket.
Yeah, what's that like to be in that bracket?
Oh, I'm not anymore, so it's fine. I have to
trash talk now before I lose everything.
Yeah, well, I mean, that's good, because you can answer your own question in a short way. Oh my gosh, all the poison spiders all of a sudden.
Yeah, you're supposed to pet them all. So you get an achievement, I think.
Howitzer, like, derped, and he was trying to hit W and hit Q and threw his pick into the lava.
Oh, really?
So he started using creepers to blow up the ores so he could collect them.
That is epic.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, that is just mean.
He was selling vending books for like 32 diamonds or something crazy. And he was getting it too. He was making bank.
Wow. Yeah, so we're supposed to collect gold and iron.
Diamonds with a lot of books. I feel like I'm gonna have to nickel and dime this win.
Nickel and dime? How does that work with this?
You know, like I'm gonna win just by redstone and lapis rather than all the stuff that matters.
Oh man.
Oh, that's probably why there's only one Vayner.
Oh.
Wait, what? What did they say?
I don't know. You officially and undeniably declare yourself the loser of this match and give the points and prestige to Hodag. Something like that.
It's a competition to see how much spider webs we can get caught in. I think I'm winning. Uh-oh.
Like, even
uh-oh.
For myself. Although, I'm not
used to it. Get the diamonds before the light. And I think we're out of time. Yep, we're out of time. That's it.
I'm counting this last one I got. Alright, that's 140 points plus 37,000.
Alright. Do railroad tracks count for anything?
No. Stop. I'm trying to do math here, man. She's peeking at everybody's stuff. Nosy Addy.
I would say 7, dude. I think music discs are about as common as...
I'll value it at 7, and then depending on the score, we can reevaluate or something. Oh, God, you wanted a Sires.
Well, why are you set up right next to me?
I came over. I thought we were doing a thing, man. I'll do the same way you got. It's not bad, though. There's a lot. We did have a huge haul here. Yeah, I believe that's what I ended with. Oh, no, 337 if we count the 7.
Holy cow, you got a lot of armor.
Yeah. Found a zombie spawner pretty early on.
Get out of the freaking way, Addy. 48 more points.
Yeah, that was definitely what did it. Well, GG, man.
Yeah.
Good work. I'm not sure why Addy's here, but anyway. GG. Oh, crap. I thought with you looking at her, she would, like, blame you, but then I realized I was the one holding the bow still. Yes, you guys, we did lose to BC, but you know what? 330, not a bad score, okay? It's not like there was a shout-out or anything. Shout-out, not a shout-out. But it was a respectable score. The dude just beat me. Together, I think we doubled the earnings. I think I mentioned that of the whole, like, round of everything. And right now I'm in the process, you know, of moving all my stuff because it's been 3 days since my last recording, since I said I was going to work on this, and you can see I got the floor done. I had to widen our elevator because the slime chunks are 16 by 16. That's an even number, and so are the surrounding stairs and everything. So this was going to be the odd kind of thing out. So I widened it, even though slime is only shooting up one side. It doesn't matter. It looks all right. Then I finished the walls. You can see I put the pumpkins in. I went with the pumpkins instead of the magma blocks. Those just weren't doing it with lighting. I would have had to put way more, and it wasn't going to be cool. I might come back eventually and replace all these with sea lanterns because I like those way better. But I finished those. I went with the buttons, cracked stone brick, regular. I went with stairs. I went with a little bit of everything. Threw some vines in it. And it looks pretty funky. And I finished the roof as well, which I really... quite like just the kind of randomness of it. In fact, this whole thing is kind of random and just odd looking. Then I went ahead and I finished all of the walls, like straight up the side. I finished every single wall, every wall like this. I went straight up with the mossy stone brick and with the pumpkins and with the what's that called, trapdoors over them. I finished that part, and then I started putting floors in. Then I put these side The sliminess level 1. Put these side little things, little stairs to get up to the second level. You know, finish the second level. And I have been playing a lot these last 2 days, you guys. And I love how this looks. It's such a jungle temple kind of deal. And just keep going up the stairs. The stairs are all down, however, levels 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. I haven't been able to change the wall and get the different variants going yet, but I will do that eventually. Might happen to have to happen on a live stream or something. But you can see that I've been extremely busy. You can go up every single staircase. By the way, the opposite staircase on the other side is also done. If you look down into it, you can see the slimes are still spawning. In fact, at this point, I have about a double chest and a half full of slime blocks. It's getting kind of obscene. And just because I've been spending so much time here, even though I'm in the proximity of the farm and it's not really working that great. And then all the way out to here, both sides. Like I said, this other side is done as well, right here. And so now I'm ready, you guys. I wanted to get all that done. I thought about putting out a Wednesday episode just for that, but I think I'm going to save this till Sunday just in case something else goes wrong with my computer. And then you guys will at least have a Sunday episode. But yeah, we are ready, and I think I have the resources ready as well to start our next project right here. And I'm pretty excited for that one too. So you guys, remember I said, oh, last episode, oh no, the lucky break gain is gone. Well, Dragon Tech commented and was like, dude, I didn't get to play it either. It's kind of a bummer. And then I was like, yeah, and we were kind of like joking about how much of a bummer it was. And it is a bummer, don't get me wrong. But, yeah, Coach Azarito heard it. And he's like, okay, fine. I restocked it. Shut up, basically. So here we go. I'm going to play, I don't know. Let's play 5. No. Ooh, I accidentally put 6. I guess we have to play 6. I didn't get to play it any of the other times, you guys. So you know what? I'm playing it 6 times. We're going to do this one. And boats and hose, of course. Of course. What a junk. You know what? He's reset it, and it's been a complete... A cookie? Really? Really? Did I just pick the worst ones? Nether bricks. You know what, Cortez? This better start improving. Okay, I've made 3 so far, right? I got 3. Okay, so I got to break 3 more. And I'm just doing this because I need some space. So far, not impressed, Cortez. You better not have, like, pranked this and just made them all kind of junky. One of these better have diamonds in it. That's not bad or good. I got one more. This one better be magnificent. Andesite? Really? I feel like the other ones that I've seen in other videos were a lot better than that. Did I just pick a bunch of junk ones? I mean, some of the stuff is good. You can always use the ore, the quartz, and glass is always good. But I feel like the prizes were bigger in the other ones. Maybe I just have terrible luck. Maybe that's it. Maybe I'm just doomed to have terrible luck. And that's the end of it. Anyway, whatever. It's a fun game. I like it. And people are always, you know, I like it because you're addicted to gambling all the time, you know. We're going to go up to the top here and say goodbye to everybody. Nope, I like it down here. We're not going to go up to the top. I like it right here. Okay. Ooh, look at that. It's beautiful, I think. Anyway, you guys, even though we have horrible luck, this place is beautiful. The slime farm is coming along. Very beautiful, I think. I love it, absolutely. It's just, it's costing me hours of my life, but it's going to be epic when it gets done. And a lot of other good things are happening here on the server. Like I said, Leon just finished his sugarcane farm. It should be epic. I got some in a live stream the other day. I mapped out where our, what's it called? Skyscraper? Skyscraper is going to be going soon, so that should be heading up pretty soon. And a couple other things in mind that we want to work on too, including maybe some sea lanterns in the future with Howitzer. And who knows, you guys? I have like 10 to 20 ideas written down right now, and I don't even know which one to do next. It's crazy. So anyway, you guys, thank you guys for watching today. I hope you have a great day, and see you next time.